Alright guys, before we get into the video real fast, we have a like goal for this video, guys. Can we smash 115 likes? We also have a question of the day coming in right here. Who is the best power-up player you currently have on your team? Enjoy the video, guys. Alright guys, I'm adding two big, huge pieces to my team. We have Michael Thomas, powered up from very bottom all the way up to the very top. I don't know why it started at the top of the set and went all the way down, but this is going to be around 1.4 million coins worth of upgrades to my squad here, adding probably the two best receivers in the game when it comes to overall wise. Obviously, Julio Jones being the best in the game, and of course, Michael Thomas, you know, being the best when it comes to helping out the whole entire team. Him adding, you know, his plus two to catching is pretty amazing. Also, he already has a pretty amazing card. After that, guys, we're going to go ahead and show you a gameplay with my squad, with Julio Jones 99 overall, with Mr. 98 overall, Randy Moss, and of course, the Michael Thomas powered up all the way. I'm going to go ahead and show you guys a gameplay with those guys. So right here, as you can see, I am just finishing up building Michael Thomas, and again, Michael Thomas just completely a beast. A little bit slow with the speed of 93. You know, not the biggest fan of that. Obviously, John Madden does boost him up to 93, but just not the biggest fan of his speed. His speed is a tad bit slow, but nonetheless, as you can see right here, we are finishing up Michael Thomas, and then we will go ahead and have our 98 overall wide receiver, which in my opinion does have the best chems in the game. He has ground and pound and go deep, so he helps him out in the run blocking ability, and he also helps himself out when it comes to just overall receiver. You see right here, he does have 93 speed when it comes to John Madden being added to him. So now we're going to go ahead and go and power up Mr. Julio Jones, who I, in my opinion, is the best wide receiver in the game. Randy Moss is very, very close second to him, I feel like. But you guys are going to see what his stats look like with John Madden and, of course, Michael Thomas. Now, I do not have him maxed out at Go Deep Tier 5. If I did, he would be even more insane. But to be honest, his stats already are a lot of 99 overalls. So right here, we're going to go ahead and buy him, and let's go ahead and put him into the set and power him up, which is honestly the stupidest decision just because of the fact he is honestly not too much better being powered up. It's not really worth to power him up, but of course, I do this for you guys for entertainment purposes. So this is going to be what he looks like with John Madden and the rest of the team, of course. I've not put too many upgrades on my team. I don't play online as much as others do. So obviously, I've not, you know, put too many, like, just upgrading the team. My offensive line is complete booty butt cheeks, and of course, you know, team wise we have a pretty decent squad. 96 overall, not too bad. Defensively, we're not the best either. We have a decent defense, you know, a solid 95 overall defense. Well, let's get right into our first gameplay, guys. And the guy I'm playing actually has, I believe, a 98 overall squad. He had 99 Rod Woodson, 99 LT, and then 99 LT. So the halfback and the outside linebacker. He had a pretty good squad, and looking at his cornerbacks a little bit, he had, I believe, 99 Woodson. He had 97, 96, and 95. So he had a pretty decent squad. A little bit better than mine overall wise. And when I say, what I mean by that is, obviously, my team is really nice and, you know, juiced at all positions, but there's a lot of holes on my team, and that's the main issue, I feel like. But anyway, first out of 10, he's going to go ahead and check it down. First time ever playing Barry Sanders, and I kind of was scared to play him because, of course, he does have 97, 98 plus speed. So it's always scary to play players with those, you know, key attributes. But it doesn't matter because we have the goons on defense. And no matter what players I play on defense, I always feel like I have, like, the best defense. I don't know why. It just might be me. But right here, you're going to go ahead and start taking off running with Aaron Rodgers. Fumbles the ball, and Marshawn Lattimore picks it up for 6. Touchdown, just like that. We were up 14-0. And to be honest, when I'm in these type of games, I kind of feel scared because I don't want the person I'm playing to quit right away, right? When I'm playing, trying to get a gameplay for you guys for the channel, I don't want someone to quit right away in the game. I want them to stay in the game for a very good amount of time so I can go ahead and get as many highlights and, you know, gameplay as possible. When you go up by 14 points in any Madden game, it's almost like guaranteed if your opponent does not score a touchdown on that given drive, they're probably going to go ahead and quit the game. And that's what's really disappointing. But I knew this game was not going to last too long. Once I took a 14-point lead, I knew my opponent probably was going to go ahead and try to get out of this game quickly. Fourth down and 10 here, he's going to go ahead and catch me napping. I was running Tampa 2 to stop this, but I did base the line. If you base the line in Tampa 2, you pretty much give the corner routes like that wide open catches. So you have to go ahead and make sure you don't base the line in those situations. As he's going to go ahead and run the ball again. And secure tackle, unfakeable, definitely amazing chemistry in that those situations. As my guy drops a wide open interception, but of course that's going to be Madden. Now the last time I played online I believe was like 2 months ago. So, you know, playing online for the first time in a while, I can kind of see exactly what I left off on with, you know, a lot of people running exact same plays over and over and over again, which I used to do. I'm getting away from that, but you know, it's just how online is. There's a lot of key plays people run, and they run them over and over and over again. Right here, though, 3rd and 3, he's gonna go ahead and try to catch me off sides. Ends up failing. He ends up trying to run here with his quarterback Aaron Rodgers, and Kwon Short, my D tackle, actually goes ahead and tackles him, bringing it up 4th down and 4, where he tries to throw it quickly, and Dontelio Poe is gonna go ahead and pick him off. So, not much of a gameplay, guys, but thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe button. And real fast, guys, Julio Jones is the best wide receiver in this game. Don't even at me. Look at Julio Jones right here. He is so good. My opponent's going to quit the game and get the heck on out of here. Definitely was not happy about this game on his end. But thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.